Hello and welcome everybody to OCW Slam Fest, taking place at the Stormont Valley Event Center in Topeka, Kansas for the Taco and Margarita Festival. We're here at the OCW HQ. I'm Dane G. Kroll, and with me is the Chicano Terror, Michael Ortega, and Nature's Fury, JC Thunder.
Whoa, first of all, let's get the introduction correct. When you say Nature's Fury, JC Thunder, you forgot to include the former heavyweight champion of OCW, the GOAT of OCW.
Let's get the introductions correct. Ladies and gentlemen, Nature's Fury, former OCW heavyweight champion, the GOAT of OCW, JC Thunder. Well, it was a wild day for OCW, and we've got more to come for you tonight. Kid USA is set for a rematch against the OCW Kansas champion, Mr. Fitness 2, after their match earlier in the day ended when Mr. Fitness 2 struck Kid USA over the head with a shake weight.
Well, I'll tell you right now, Mr. Fitness 2, a former tag team partner myself, the man who claims to have a $1 million body, but I guarantee you, with inflation, it's a $1.5 million body.
You think he's gonna put the title back up on the line? Is he gonna be able to handle this?
He is a fighting champion. So, Kid USA, I hope he brings everything he has.
And I understand, you know, now Kid USA is getting that second chance, but the question does remain, will Kid USA be in any condition to compete in another match, Michael?
Well, I'm not sure if he's gonna get cleared by the doctors. I mean, he took a shot, and I don't believe he'll be cleared for the match. It's not good for him.
All right, the question still looms. We are waiting to hear from the medical professionals in the back. But in our main event, the Mangler is knocking at death's door when he goes up against the reigning OCW heavyweight champion, him the Scarecrow. Now, I don't think it'll be an easy feat for Mangler here.
No, I guarantee it will not be an easy feat. For one, him the Scarecrow, he climbed the mountain of the Midwest. He defeated me, of all people. I am the GOAT, I'm the former heavyweight champion, so I will give props and respects to him, the Scarecrow. Mangler, I don't know what you did to get to this title shot, but good luck.
Did you think Mangler has what it takes to dethrone the Scarecrow?
I don't believe so. I think with Scarecrow and his ability in the ring, it's not gonna happen. I think Scarecrow retains his title tonight.
An insurmountable force right there. But first, coming up next, after a tag team match gone wrong, Kyle King is now challenging Dr. Eisen for the OCW U.S. Heavyweight Champion. And I think that's going to be a good one, guys. What do you think?
You know, Dr. Eisen is he is a doctor. He is crafty. He is smart. He has held that title for a long time. So, you know, Kyle King, you're a proud man. You're a good fighter. You're a great wrestler. But you better, step up a notch.
All right. Well, let's take it to our ring announcer, Daniel Brown, to kick off the action.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Stormont Vale Event Center in Topeka, Kansas. We are OCW Professional Wrestling, and this is Slam Fest at the Tacos and Margarita Festival. This show is brought to you with a partnership with Fox 43, Stormont Vale Event Center, Adrenaline Championship Wrestling, and Michael Ortega. So with no more delay, this is OCW! The following match is for one fall, and it's for the OCW U.S. Championship with a 10-minute TV time limit. From parts unknown, weighing 220 pounds, too weird to live, too strange to die, Kyle King!
And while Kyle King makes his way down to the ring, let's go back and see the events that led up to this point. After losing a tag team match with his partner, Dr. Eisen, the two of them found themselves at odds after their match leading to tonight's title bout. Well, certainly a strange way to find yourself in a title match, but let's hear what Kyle King has to say about the whole thing.
I love doctors. You know, Kyle King's been to so many doctors and had so many, well, let's be realistic, pills. And you, Dr. Eisen, were one of my favorite doctors until, you lost the match and I was okay with you losing. But then to try and attack my beautiful, sometimes, face is hurtful to me. And I know what's hurtful to you is going to be me taking your United States championship. Now, I don't really know where I'm from, to be perfectly honest. The United States, I'm a citizen of the world, so I got that going for me. So I don't know the legalities of many things, and I certainly don't know the legalities of holding that belt, but I'm going to beat you, and I'm going to take it, and then you're going to be hurting.
Specialist, an honorary graduate from the University of Guadalajara online, weighing 213 pounds, Dr. Eisen!
Dr. Eisen willing to put his title up on the line against Kyle King after his loss.
Well, that right there just shows you what kind of a champion he is. He had a match earlier in the day. He did lose, but he took that loss in stride. He's putting it behind him. Now he's putting that title up for grabs.
And let's hear what Dr. Issa has to say now about his challenger, Kyle King.
Kyle King, you cost us that match, and I am looking for my revenge. So today, tonight, we're gonna do a US Championship match, okay? And you're not gonna get away with it unscathed. No, you're gonna be lacerated, concussed, bruised, and you'll be lucky if you even have a pulse.
Let's see if Dr. Eisen can back up his words right there. Kyle King's got more than a pulse. He is ready to go.
Well, right now, all I can say is Dr. Eisen, I hope he doesn't make house calls, but I think he's going to answer this call to Kyle King.
Gloating a little big, showing off the title belt. I'm worried that Dr. Eisen isn't going to be ready for this. Now, you said he's a fighting champion, JC, but I don't know. He could still be getting his head. He just took a pin. He took a pinfall, and Kyle King was not there.
He did take that pinfall, but remember, that was in a tag team match. This is a singles match. This is his forte. The doctor, regardless of how he got his degree, he is an intelligent man, and he is a fighting champion.
Course. And then Kyle King, we just saw there, rubbing his beard on the title bell. A little luck right there, I hope.
I think he's just polishing it up for when he gets it tonight.
Could we be seeing a new U.S. heavyweight champion? We'll find out shortly. And here we go. The bell is rung. OCW Slamfest has officially started. And with Dr. Eisen not even looking at his opponent. Uh-oh.
Looks like Kyle King's going to go in for a prostate check there.
Luckily, Dr. Eisen kind of saw what Kyle King was up to. Again, the bell is rung. You do not want to turn your back to an opponent right now.
No.
I mean, go ahead, JC.
Well, I was just going to say, these are two very crafty veterans of the ring. Both of them have been in that squared circle. They know what they're doing. It's just a matter of trust and who's willing to, you know, make that first strike.
Kyle King showing a lot of trust right now. Again, turning his back now to Dr. Eisen. But he's getting the love from the crowd.
Yeah, pandering to that crowd is not going to win the championship. I guarantee you that.
Dr. Rice, he's got the gloves on. He might be ready for that park door exam.
Well, whatever you got to do to win, get that win.
See, now they finally notice each other in the ring here. Sharing a few words. Let's see if Kyle King can get into Dr. Rice's head.
It's a matter of who's going to step up and make that first strike.
Kyle King has all the tools to take that championship tonight, though. If I was a betting man, my money would be on Kyle King tonight.
He's got the momentum on his side, I think. At least more than Dr. Eisen, I would say. And the first strike goes to Kyle King, actually.
See, there he is, biting. Now, that is against the rules, and he knows that. The referee needs to step up, stand in, and enforce those rules.
Referee Nick Chin did warn him. So he's got his work cut out as referee with these two guys tonight.
Kyle King with the unorthodox wrestling style. Is he going for another bite? See, Dr. Eisen's got to not fall for that.
See, the referee's got to get in there and break that count, break that hold.
Once again, falling into another trap of Kyle King's. Right in there into a little camel clutch. Again, rubbing the beard a little bit on Dr. Eisen's head. Is it a luck thing? Is it a insult?
I think he's just trying to get in the head of Dr. Eisen, but I think Dr. Eisen is too educated for that.
Ooh, high kick did not pay off for Kyle King right there. Oh, he looks like he's about to go for a ride.
Using the ropes to his advantage, though. That is the intelligent part of Dr. Eisen.
They say that's how Dr. Eisen does a lot of his exams with his patients. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back at the action after this. We are now back to OCW Slam Fest here at the Stormont Valley Event Center for the Taco and Margarita Festival. Kyle King is currently getting dissected by Dr. Eisen, the U.S. champion.
Well, Dr. Eisen's showing why he is a champion. He's taking advantage, keeping Kyle King down on that mat. Yep, using his full advantage right now.
A blow right to the back, keeping Kyle King on the ground. Kyle King's unorthodox, you know, fighting, I think it's not doing him any good right now. Dr. Eisen, as you said, is holding him down, just keeping him at bay.
Yeah, see Dr. Eisen right now applying that chin lock, grabbing onto the beard of Kyle King, his what apparently seems to be his source of strength.
Now where's the rest? See, he was counting there. You can't hold onto the beard, right?
I think the referee was looking at the tacos, he was looking at the margaritas, he's not paying attention.
But Kyle King's starting to fight back now. Some European uppercut straight to the chin of Dr. Eisen. But it didn't come out enough.
Nope, inverted atomic drop, that'll stop you in your tracks.
Nice clothesline.
If Kyle King doesn't change what he's doing, this match is over.
Maybe he's got to get the biting back going again. That seemed to be effective earlier in the match.
Oh, most definitely. He's got to go back to his unorthodox style. That's the only way he's going to get the victory tonight.
See the referee in there checking, making sure Eisen has that clean chin lock on him. Dr. Eisen, a very notable doctor in Guadalajara.
Online.
Online.
He's all over the message boards, giving out tips and tricks that you'll never believe. But Kyle King here calling for the crowd to try to get him some energy to find out of Dr. Eisen's grip.
Yeah, once again, he's pandering to that crowd. He needs to focus, and just like that, he loses that focus.
But he gains his strength from the crowd, and that's one thing that Kyle King does. The crowd loves him, whether he's doing good, doing bad. The crowd loves Kyle King.
Yeah, but the love of that crowd will not win you championships, Mike. I know that of all people. You win by winning.
You are correct, JC.
Of course I am.
Bit of a low blow there. Couldn't really tell too much, but that's, again, the precision work of Dr. Eisen.
That's right. He has the precision of a surgeon. What you think was a low blow, that was a strict headbutt to the lower ab region. Strictly legal.
Maybe we should ask Kyle King about that one. Check out the bill that Dr. Eisen's going to give him. Again, the strikes right to the shoulders, the neck, and that lower chin of Kyle King, but he's ducking out.
You see Kyle King's wore down. He's not taking advantage of that time. He needs to use that momentum. Strike fast, strike hard.
Another chop to Dr. Eisen. You can almost feel it from here.
You can feel it from here, and I have felt it before, and I will tell you right now, they don't feel good.
Kyle King is exhausted. I'm not sure he's going to have what it takes to win this match.
To understand, both these men did have a match earlier in today, so you know that has to take effect on their cardiovascular, on their their mental fortitude. Do they have enough?
And Kyle King was kind of hoping, once again, that Dr. Eisen was more worn down than him, but it turns out that might not be the case. Dr. Eisen is ready for this fight.
Well, as a champion, he's always ready. It just, how much more does he have in the tank?
Kyle King getting weird, charging up. With a major clothesline down to Dr. Eisen, keeping him off his feet. This could be Kyle King's chance to turn everything around.
And just like that, stops that momentum.
Oh, and he's back. The straight kick to the side of the head. Dr. Eisen is down. He needs to capitalize. He needs to get a pinfall.
You're right. He's not taking advantage of that time down.
Going for that flip off the top rope, but Dr. Eisen, he studied. He was there. He put his knees up, knew what was going to happen.
He is a man of knowledge. He studies books. He studies people. He studies wrestling, and that's what makes him a great champion.
What about now? Dr. Eisen seems to be getting his belt. Is he on his way out? Ooh, no, he's getting back to the ring with it.
No, I think he's just going to show Kyle King what he wishes he could win and take home tonight.
Maybe rub the beard with it a little bit, give Dr. Eisen a little bit of luck.
See, the referee should not be stepping in there. Dr. Eisen.
And a low blow behind the ref's back.
Taking advantage of the situation.
That could have been a disqualification for the ref trying to return the ring. And he kicks out. Kyle King is still in it.
He's working purely off adrenaline right now, I guarantee you. And this is where Dr. Eisen needs to step up his game and bring it to Kyle King.
He needs to make this match an A if he wants to pass this course against Kyle King. And a super kick. To Kyle King.
Could this be it?
Two. And there's the three. Kyle King that loses to Dr. Eisen. Unbelievable. I think it was that low blow that Dr. Eisen threw over to Kyle King that did it in for him.
You know, Dan, you may say unbelievable, but here you will see the referee hand Dr. Eisen's belt. And that's about as believable as it can be.
Is this what they teach at Guadalajara Online? How to cheat?
Well, you know what? It's an online school. It's a very reputable school. So,
the Harvard of Mexico. It is the Harvard of Mexico, and he has an honorary degree from there.
Dr. Eisen is celebrating the ring.
And he still has that belt.
But we've got more action to come, ladies and gentlemen. Coming up in our main event, it's Hin the Scarecrow versus the Mangler. And let's hear what the Mangler has to say.
Scarecrow, coming all the way to my home state of Kansas from the land of the damned. But I'm going to tell you something, brother. By the end of this show, you're going to be the one damned. I'm going to take you, I'm going to put my boots to you, and by the end of this show, you're going to understand why they call me the only real wrestler. You, Scarecrow, will be the only one scared, crawling yourself right back to the locker room. So think twice, Scarecrow, because I'm the Mangler, and I am the only real wrestler.
Can the only real wrestler stand up against him, the Scarecrow? We'll find out later tonight. But coming up next, Mr. Fitness 2 puts his OCW Kansas Championship on the line up against Kid USA in a rematch from earlier today. Now the question remains, will Kid USA be medically cleared for this title match? We'll find out after the break. Welcome back to OCW Slam Fest at the Stormont Valley Events Center. The OCW Kansas champion, Mr. Fitness 2, is set to defend his title against Kid USA. However, there is one caveat. Is Kid USA going to be cleared? Earlier in the day, these two already met, and this is how it ended.
Mr. Fitness 2, the Million Dollar Body, I'm your Kansas Heavyweight Champion for a reason. And Kid USA, you should have known not to ever get in the ring with me. You think I wasn't going to knock you senseless with this shake weight? And for some reason, you think you're going to get cleared on time to get back in the ring with me? Not in 30 days, not in 90 days. You just go to the retirement home where you belong. I'm the Million Dollar Body, Mr. Fitness 2. Let's shake it up.
Now, medical professionals are in the back checking over Kid USA, but with an unknown prognosis, it's hard to say what will happen next. Michael, do you think he's going to be ready for this?
I still don't think the doctor's going to clear him. I think he's out this match.
And do you think it's a physical thing or do you think like a mental? Is he ready to face Mr. Fitness 2 once again?
He took a solid shot, and I just don't believe he's going to be able to be cleared by doctors. Mm-hmm. I think he definitely has a concussion.
Of course. And JC, former tag team partners of Mr. Fitness 2.
Well, in my opinion, I think Kid USA, you're running scared. Yeah, you took a little bit of a shot to the noggin. But come on, representing the USA, stand up, step up, take the challenge to Mr. Fitness. But
it's time, Sam. Do you think Mr. Fitness 2 is obligated to defend the title again, or him using the shake weight against Kid USA, is that fair?
Obligations or not, Mr. Fitness is a stand-up man. So as a champion, he'll take on all comers.
Let's take it down to Daniel Brown in the ring.
Due to the incidents earlier tonight, Michael Ortega has ordered that Kid USA get a rematch for the Kansas Championship against Mr. Fitness 2. However, following doctor's recommendation, Kid USA will not be able to compete in the rematch.
And here Mr. Fitness comes to gloat. Kid USA can't compete. He doesn't even need to be coming down here right now.
Look, Mr. Fitness, my former tag team partner, the man with a $1 million body, but I guarantee you, he's got every right to gloat. He's still carrying that Kansas championship.
He's only carrying it right now because he had to cheat, JC.
You call it cheating, we call it winning. That's all that matters, winning.
What's he even doing down here?
Like I said, he is the champion, and the people deserve to see the champion, and that's what he's here to do.
Mr. Fitness 2, from the world-renowned Rose Garden, led by the Midnight Rose, may he rest in peace. But he has continued his legacy for Midnight Rose, and he's taking over. He's just been doing so great in everything he's done. He's a champion everywhere he goes.
Hey, when I'm talking, you pay attention.
Pay attention, Michael.
I will.
A little rude, but I'll accept that. This is your champion talking, by the way. I'm talking to you Kansas hillbillies. When I knocked him out cold in this ring, I told you he wasn't coming back. But I've got good news. I may not have an opponent, but you guys get to witness the $1 million body one more time. What do you think about that?
I don't think the crowd wants to see that again.
Well, they should be privileged. I mean, this is a...
Oh, see, my.
There it is. There it is. And like I said, with inflation, that's a $1.5 million body.
He could have stayed in the back for this.
Because inflation hit him hard.
If something hit him hard.
There's a lot of ladies out there, though, that like that. So he's just giving the ladies what they want, I guess.
Arnold Schwarzenegger, eat your heart out. You know, there's a lot of body guys.
I hear some familiar music here.
What's going on here?
It's Chocolate Violence coming out. What do they want?
Is for one fall and is a non-title match with 10-minute TV time limit from Dodge City, Kansas, weighing an order of tacos and an ice-cold Mexican Coke, Bruisador Violence! His opponent already in the ring, your OCW Kansas champion from the almighty Rose Garden, weighing a fit 195 pounds, Mr. Fitness 2.
Bruisador Violence stepping up to the plate to challenge Mr. Fitness 2 in this impromptu match. Being so sudden, who has the advantage right now? We have Mr. Fitness 2, Kansas champion, against a tag team opponent, but he's not ready for it.
But still, he has the advantage based on the fact that, as I said before, he is a champion. And as a champion that I know he is, he'll be ready.
A champion is always prepared.
You may be right.
See,
right there,
he is. Taking advantage of the situation.
Oh, it might not have had any effect on him, though. Shaking off those strikes from Mr. Fitness 2, and he's running away now.
He's giving Bruisador an opportunity. That's what he's doing, is giving Bruisador an opportunity to catch his breath, to think about, is he good enough to defeat Mr. Fitness?
Well, Faz might think, I don't think he is.
See,
Faz,
there he is.
Off at the ramp right there.
Threatening with a foreign object.
Mr. Fitness 2 just threw the cigarette at Faz.
See, now come on. You're going for his mask, and there he is. Mr. Fitness taking advantage of the situation, of his surroundings, using that ring to his advantage.
A chaotic start to the match here, but it seems we're finally underway. Mr. Fitness 2 taking control early on now.
And Bruisador, usually being in a tag team match, he's used to not having to work the whole match. He's able to tag out, get his rest. This is going to be one of the matches where we're going to see what kind of cardio he has and if he can do it on his own.
Paz cheering him on. I think, I'm going to guess, he's going to want to try to tag out at some point. But to your credit, Michael, you're right. He can't tag out. He is on his own in this match against the Kansas champion. But once again, shrugging off Mr. Fitness 2's blows. Going for the mask, huh?
Oh,
nice right to the eyes.
No, strictly just rubbing his face. There it is, stiff clothesline.
Bringing Bruisador.
Showing that body off. Showing that $1.5 million body. I guarantee you, Dan, there's a lot of jealous people in the crowd right now.
Mr. Fitness 2 needs a refund. The Bruisador once again rallying back up to his feet. The crowd is firmly behind him, wanting to see Mr. Fitness 2 taking down a peg after his dastardly actions against Kid USA earlier today.
See, the referee needs to step in there. He's using closed fist, which is illegal in the sport of wrestling.
Nice clothesline. Massive clothesline right there to Mr. Fitness 2. Paz hyping up the crowd in the back. Bruisador calling for the crowd to count with them.
See, he's going to be lucky to get this crowd to count with him. I don't know how many you can even count that high to begin with.
They seem to be doing fine, JC.
Like I said, the referee needs to step in there. Those are illegal closed fists he's using.
The referee's
using some... See, Paz is interfering. He shouldn't be interfering in this match. It's
Mr.
a singles
Fitness
match.
Mr. Fitness 2 is going for a shake weight. Memories of the match against Kid USA. Slamming Mr. Fitness 2 down to the ring head first. And there's the three.
That's Bruisador, one of the biggest upsets I've seen in OCW ever.
With a huge upset against Mr. Fitness 2 out of nowhere.
He got that upset due to outside interference by that man right there. Paz had no reason to be interfering in that match.
Mr. Fitness 2 possibly eyeing to cheat, but Paz stopped him, looking for that shake weight as a possible weapon against Bruisador, and it turned foul for him.
That victory ought to push Bruisador up to the number one contender for that OCW Kansas Championship.
Well, that's a great opportunity for Bruisador, but let's go to the back where our camera's caught up to Kid USA after his incident with the shake weight earlier.
These guys stop carrying that to the ring. That's how everyone would go. I thought I was smarter than that. All I did was come here to Topeka with one goal, and that was to beat Mr. Fitness and run out of tacos. I didn't have no tacos, but I won. But, God, I didn't get the belt. I failed. I gotta work my way back up that I can't even think straight. I think I have a concussion.
Well, we certainly hope to see Kid USA back in action soon. But coming up next, it's our main event when him, the Scarecrow, puts his OCW heavyweight title up against the Mangler. And the Scarecrow has a few words for his challenger.
Mangler, when you mention the Scarecrow name, you made your worst bad life decision. And if you think that for one second, because you're in your hometown, Kansas, that you're gonna come up in that ring and gonna take my OCW Heavyweight Championship, you're sadly mistaken. Because just like everyone else, when they step foot in the ring with the Scarecrow, you will face the terror.
Same words from the Scarecrow. We'll be right back after this. Welcome back to OCW Slam Fest. Now we're getting ready for the main event. The OCW Heavyweight Champion, him, the Scarecrow, goes one-on-one with the Mangler. Now, JC, you were in the ring with the Scarecrow not long ago. What's it going to take for the Mangler to take him down?
It's going to take everything he has, and I'm not 100% certain he's got enough. You know, him, the Scarecrow, a student of the Dudley Brothers School. But the Mangler, in his back pocket, is a student of the Nasty Boys School of Training. So you have two legendary tag teams right there representing in this ring today.
I think it's going to be a great match. It's going to be hard-hitting. It's going to be one to enjoy.
All right. Well, we'll see if the Mangler has what it takes. Let's take it down to Daniel Brown in the ring to fire up the action.
The following match is for one fall and is for the OCW World Heavyweight Championship. With a 15-minute TV time limit. From Wichita, Kansas, weighing 350 pounds, your number one contender, the Mangler!
Mangler making his way to the ring now. Now, JC, we've talked about this in the past. Do you think he's mentally ready to go up against him, the Scarecrow?
No, I don't think the Mangler's ready for anything, to be honest with you. Look at him.
He's paying too much attention to the crowd right there more than he is the match.
Well, he's gonna have to pay attention to the match because I guarantee you, him, the Scarecrow, he is gonna be a formidable opponent.
Not too happy with the crowd's reactions to him. Mangler is going to have to focus if he wants to take the title off of him, the Scarecrow.
Well, I'm not too sure who the Mangler beat to deserve this number one contender match, but I guarantee you he's going to will have his hands full against him, the Scarecrow.
A little disrespect to Daniel right there.
The Mangler needs to be worried more about Scarecrow than he has to be about the crowd and the ring announcer,
and
Daniel Brown.
Making a lot of enemies.
Your OCW
and Daniel Brown, he's no slouch either. That's a big guy.
From the land
hate to see Mangler
damned,
get knocked out before his match.
Weighing 265 pounds, him, the Scarecrow!
Every time I see Scarecrow, I just get goosebumps. I just get that little bit of fear. There's just that aura about him that scares me. I ain't gonna lie. This guy scares me.
I think a chill running down everybody's spine here at the Stormont Vail Event Center. The OCW Heavyweight Champion, JC. What's it like to see him coming out here right now?
Well, I guarantee you, just like what Mike said, and I hate to agree with what Mike says, but it is a chilling experience to be standing across the ring from him, the Scarecrow. He did defeat me for that title. I will give him props. He is or at least he was the better man for one day.
Mangler getting ready, getting psyching himself up, I think. As him, the Scarecrow, stays composed.
It's gonna take a lot more than what Mangler has to rattle the Scarecrow, I guarantee you that. Already the Mangler's already left the ring.
We're in hallowed halls here at the Stormont Vail Event Center. Former champions such as Hulk Hogan, Cody Rhodes have been in this ring in the Stormont Vail Event Center, and now him, the Scarecrow, and the Mangler.
And even history goes back further than that there, Dane. I've witnessed when I was a young child seeing Harley Race wrestle in this building.
Very true.
As well as Hulk Hogan, Ric Flair, The Undertaker.
All the
Terry
greats.
Funk, all the greats of wrestling. Even J.C. Thunder's grace the halls of the Stormont Vail Center.
Mangler just has that fear in his eyes. I don't think he wants to be there today. It sounded like a good idea when he signed the contract, but right now, it don't look like he wants to be there.
Like those greats that we just named, the Mangler is going to have to step up.
He's going to have to step up. He's going to have to step in that ring. He's got to put any fear that he has aside. Take that aggression that he has towards that crowd and put it towards the Scarecrow.
He's got a lot of fear.
Still uneasy, hesitant to jump in the ring, yelling to get him back.
Well, I guarantee you the Scarecrow will not back down. The Mangler's gonna have to step through those ropes and take it to the Scarecrow.
Referee Nick Chin, he's gonna have his hands full this match.
And what about the Scarecrow? Being such against such a large opponent as the Mangler, is the Scarecrow gonna have to change his style at all?
Now let's not forget, the Scarecrow is no slouch himself. 6'3", 265 pounds. He's a fairly large guy, as well as the Mangler. He's pulling my hair!
Mangler complaining about getting his hair pulled by the Scarecrow. Maybe he shouldn't have such a long style right there.
Well, I guarantee you, the Mangler, he's got more to worry about than just a little hair pull.
The Titans locking up in this main event here for Slam Fest. Driving Scarecrow into the corner.
You know, Dan, it's a great fact to know that both these guys represent two of the most legendary tag teams in the history of professional wrestling. Mangler representing the Nasty Boys, whereas him, the Scarecrow, is a student of the Dudley Boys. So two legendary Hall of Fame tag teams for sure.
The Mangler keeping on Scarecrow right now, not making any friends, yelling at Nick just a couple of moments ago. And over the top rope goes the Scarecrow, but he lands it.
It's gonna take more than that, I guarantee you. I've been in that position.
Taking this fight outside the ring now.
See, this is where the referee needs to step up his count, get control of this situation, get these guys in the ring. Matches are won and lost in the ring.
Starting the 10 count, I would hate to see this match go to a count out. I personally, as a viewer, as a lover of wrestling, I want to see this match come to a pinfall.
Well, the Mangler needs to get the match in the ring, because you can't win that title via count out.
And there
he
you
needs
go.
Needs to get him in the ring and take advantage of the situation just like that.
Back over the top rope.
Again, this time Scarecrow not landing so gingerly.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Scarecrow is down and out. Will he hold on to his OCW Heavyweight Championship? We'll find out after this break. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to OCW Slam Fest at the Stormont Valley Event Center. As we see there, the Mangler getting slammed into the corner post by him, the Scarecrow, the OCW Heavyweight Champion.
He's taking advantage of the situation, taking advantage of the surrounding.
Fan there getting into the Mangler's ear, probably not good words of encouragement.
Well, the Mangler did start it when he threw something at that guy earlier.
Threw some sunglasses at him, I think. Mangler keeping on his opponent, getting tossed out of the ring twice now. Scarecrow is getting a little bit of revenge with a hard slam to the back right there.
Right, but as we said before, he needs to get him in the ring. He needs to beat him in the center of that ring.
Getting back in the ring, Scarecrow could have taken the champion's advantage, gone for that count out, but he's throwing Mangler back in the ring. He's going to want a victory, a pinfall victory. I'm guessing, right, guys?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Any chance? Oh!
The black hole slam by the Mangler. This could be it. And no! Scarecrow
but it was
is up.
It was that lazy pin.
Absolutely, Mike. Once again, I hate to agree with you, but that lazy pin, that bad cover, that arrogance of the Mangler might have cost him that match.
And now he's putting his attention on the referee when he should be focusing on the Scarecrow.
Over the top rope once again. This time the Scarecrow sending the Mangler out of the ring.
Now for Scarecrow, if he gets counted out, he don't care. He don't lose the title.
It's true. But of course, the Scarecrow, he's going to want that victory.
Oh yeah, he's wanting
he's
to...
He's out for blood.
He's looking to punish the Mangler.
But these two Titans, the behemoths, cannot be contained by the three ropes of the ring.
Well, they need to get that match inside the ring. The referee needs to get control.
Mangler just trying to roll away,
see,
but Scarecrow...
He hooks the leg. Hooking the leg. That's
not
how you
enough.
Win that match.
Not enough this time, though. hard kick to the guts. Scarecrow now just circling the Mangler. Staying on him like a predator.
Going up to that middle rope.
Oh, he's measuring him up.
Getting ready to fire.
Ooh, slamming right on the side of the gut.
The guy can't breathe. And I tell you right now, Scarecrow needs to focus more on the Mangler and less on me.
Mangler's going to be sucking air soon enough.
Oh, he looks exhausted.
Ooh, not exhausted enough to get out of the way. Scarecrow driving his shoulder into the turnbuckle.
He needs to stay focused if he wants to win this match. No, it's just a matter of can the Mangler take advantage with the DDT. But he needs to cover. He needs to get over, hook the leg, and cover the Scarecrow if he wants to win this match.
To your point, he's wasting too much energy. He's trying to grab air, yelling at the crowd now. He needs to go for the pinfall after that.
Look at all this wasted time.
And if he's waiting for the champion to get up, he's making a big mistake.
Exactly, right there. Scarecrow back up to his feet with a strike straight into Mangler's chest.
Nice net breaker.
Swinging net breaker to the Mangler. Down in the mat. This could be the Scarecrow's chance to take back the opportunity in the ring here.
Yep, we'll see if the Mangler has enough to do to make that cover. Does he have enough just to stand up and continue this match?
Both men down. Referee at a four count now.
Mangler needs to show everybody here in the Stormontville Expo Center what he has. Does he have it in him to be the champion?
I think whoever gets their feet first wins this match.
Let's see if you're right, Michael. Mangler, he's starting to get up, but Scarecrow gets back up to his feet first. And with a big splash to the Mangler.
Yeah, the Mangler's going to have to do something drastic if he plans on taking that championship from the Scarecrow.
Following up, not letting the Mangler catch his breath, get any opportunity to escape out of these giant splashes. Oh, he's laid in wait now, like a lion in the grass.
I've been in this situation. The Mangler needs to watch what he's doing.
There's that 3D drop kick right there. Could this be it?
Mangler kicks out.
Mangler gets his shoulder up just in time.
It doesn't look like he has much left in the tank. I think this match is pretty much over.
Mangler practically being carried back up by the Scarecrow. What's he have in mind? Mangler with a reversal. Oh, Scarecrow ducking out, ducking once again. Getting back to the ropes. With a massive choke slam.
I think one. There it is.
And that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Scarecrow retains his OCW Heavyweight Championship with a devastating choke slam. The Mangler is done.
And that's what it took right there. That is why he is the heavyweight champion. And that is why he stands tall with his arm raised.
What an unbelievable matchup that was. Two Titans put it all on the line. Mangler exhausted, and Scarecrow, I want to say he's barely standing, but he does not show it.
That's a champion right there.
What is it going to take to dethrone him, the Scarecrow, of the OCW Heavyweight Championship?
It may just take me coming out of retirement.
Once again, on behalf of OCW, I'm Dane G. Kroll with Michael Ortega and JC Thunder. This has been Slamfest. Good night, everybody.